Unreal Engine 5, which will be released at the end of this year, is a compatible version of UE4 and shows high-quality graphics indistinguishable from the real thing. Art just works is the slogan of UE5. When an artist provides photorealistic graphics, it can be entered into the engine without deterioration in quality, implemented as real-time rendering, and various functions that the engine automatically handles the process. In this video, we'll take a look at two key new technologies coming in Unreal Engine 5, Nanite and Lumen.
This has to be the right way.
Nanite. Nanite stands for Virtual Micropolygon Geometry, which is a technology that automatically scales the original 3D model with hundreds of millions or billions of polygons from the SSD using the streaming technique and scales it automatically. You can reduce the number of triangles in your geometry and drastically reduce the effort of developers. So with this tech, you can apply and work with film-level art sources composed of large numbers of polygons, from ZBrush sculpting to photogrammetry scans and CAD data, directly into Unreal Engine without lowering quality. Particularly, there is no need to do any work such as polygon count optimization, draw call, LOD, normal map, etc., that developers or artists have to do several times using the engine, and it reduces working time and obtains the best quality at the same time. As an example used in the existing work method, LOD, or level of detail, is a method of rendering an object roughly when the contribution of the image to be rendered is not important. To implement this, developers and artists had to create all models at each level. For the next example, the concept of normal map is a technology that allows the data extracted from high polygons to be applied to low polygon data so that it can be viewed as a model made in the form of high polygons. This is the concept of storing the normal value of the mesh vector in a low polygon. It may be a little tricky, but if you use a normal map, you don't have to calculate a lot of polygons, reducing the burden of computation. However, there is a hassle of having to go through an additional process, such as drawing manually by calculating the angle of volume or drawing it from a high polygon model to create a normal map, as well as the limitations in which shadows and textures are revealed when viewed from a close distance. In the end, the advantage of speed from SSD was brought about by structural changes in the way polygons are rendered, streaming, resulting in quality gains and improved productivity in development. Because the core of Nanite is to read large amounts of data through streaming, of course, it is true that it takes a lot of hard space, but this means that if the compression technology gets better in the future, in the smaller size, it can process data. Lumen. How to handle lighting is an important issue for the performance of real-time rendering. Lumen is a completely dynamic global illumination, in simple terms, a solution that instantly reacts to changes in light in a 3D environment and applies them to the surroundings. The direction of the light changes according to a specific time, or even indirect light changes in real time according to the movement of light, such as in a narrow or wide area. As an example of how we used it in our existing workflow, in a game that draws more than 60 images in real time in 1 second, it is too computational to use this technology right away, so there is the light map method. The light map technique is a method of pre-computing light and shadow simulations for the currently placed terrain features, saving them in an image called a light map and loading them when the game is running to add light map information to the surface of existing material. We use the expression bake in the process of generating the light map. Because of this, artists and developers needed a lot of build time to set up the lights in advance and see the result with reflected light. In UE5, changes to the light can be reflected in real time, saving a lot of time for artists and designers and creating more dynamic scenes in UE5.
there's not much time left.
In addition to these two features, several features will be added in UE5, and it is said by Epic Games that the preview version will be released in early 2021, and the full version will be released later in 2021.
Don't fail me now.
We're looking forward to meeting this Unreal Engine 5. This is the end of the video. Thank you.
It's time to see what's next.